Hey guys, what's up? Happy holidays. Alright, well the time has come for me to finally share with you a little secret that I've been carrying around with me for 9 months. I'm pregnant! No, just kidding. But it is actually kind of like a baby. This is an origami baby, a model that I've been completely obsessed with for the last 9 months. And here's why. If I were to tell you that from a single square sheet of paper, 6-inch kami, no cutting, no taping, you could fold a double reed musical instrument with a 6-octave range and use just 3 simple folds. Would you believe me? Of course you would, because I wouldn't make something like that up. But this is for real. This is the Preedo, the paper reed ocarina, and it's a model that I've been folding like 1,000 times, like every night, and as you can see, tons of them. And I'm gonna show you how to fold it, but first I'm gonna do a little demo. So here we go. Fold number one. Fold number two. And fold number three. And here it is. Ta-da! You want to learn how to fold it? Ready, set, here it goes. Alright, so the Preedo, which I developed over 9 months, was originally inspired by this video, the one-note Preedo by Doc Sankey. Alright, so the first step to the Preedo is take the piece of paper out like this. This is Ito Kami, 6-inch paper, that's what I like to use. Alright, so fold it in half like this. And this should be perfect, but make sure that you don't use your fingernails. Just fold it just with your fingers like that, okay? Now you want to turn it over so that it looks like the front of a book and take the lower right corner, this corner, and fold it up so it goes right to the edge. It should not cross the edge, it should just go right to the edge like that. And once again, don't use your fingernails, just your fingers. Okay, now the final fold is a little bit tricky. Well, it's not tricky, it's just a valley fold. So what we're gonna do is fold this flap up, but not all the way, and we don't fold the whole thing. What we're gonna do is make a little L shape right here, and now just about an inch, flatten about an inch, and here it is. Now, one extra little thing you can do is sort of just make a cone out of this area right here. That'll make a nice chamber for the sound to resonate. All right, so now to hold it, this is the position I like to use. This right here really controls the tone, and this is just adds a little added echo. All right, so. For the higher notes, you want to bring your finger a little bit closer to your mouth, like this. I'm not pressing very hard, it's just a soft press right here, right there. And for the lowest note, you press right here, you want to lift this up a little bit so that it has a little curve there, and you press right here. So those are the low notes. And a little bit higher. And when you sense that the tone isn't really coming out again, open up, put your finger in here, your ring finger, and just push there so that you have a nice echo chamber again. As you move your hand back, it makes a lower note. With my mouth, I'm not pressing very firmly on here at all. It's very gentle. But then for the higher notes, I do. Twiggy didn't like that note. Hey guys, so here's the Preedo, and I said that it had a 6-octave range, so I'm gonna demo it right now. That's 1 octave. Two. That's 3. That's 4. That's 5. And that's 6. Duh.